A lot of people are interested in the deeper story of time, the deeper story of how we came to be, how we evolved.
Who we are today is directly linked to who we were 50,000 years ago. 50,000 years ago, we were one of many species living on the planet. In my research, I want to know what happened and we left to be the only species living currently in the world. At the moment, we know that Homo sapiens, our species, has interbred, mixed with all these archaic species like Neanderthals, Denisovans, and this has implications on diseases, on how we deal with environmental pressures around us and how we deal with pathogens, even COVID-19, for example.
It's like a universal human trait to know, to wonder about origins, I think. Mm. What we help is to try and put flesh on the bones of the ancient past.
Understanding human origins is incredibly important at the moment. What we know as anthropologists and archaeologists that humans moved across large tracts of space throughout the history is something that also helps us understand racial debates. The whiteness of Europeans has not always been that. It's only a recent, a few thousand years old trait. Finding new human fossils, understanding how these fossils relate to modern populations, to the way modern people look or behave or are able to fight specific diseases.
People living in island Southeast Asia and Papua New Guinea and places like that have DNA that derives from Denisovans that includes a range of immunological traits, things that allow those people to resist diseases in the tropics more than they could had they not had that DNA. And so there are implications for living people and the health of living people from the work that is done in the field of ancient archaeology and genomics, which is really cool.
Doctors, medical students, anthropologists were wondering how it is that Tibetans are able to live and survive on the top of the world. And suddenly, in 2011, we now know that this is a genetic trait that they received from Denisovans, this archaic species.
The crux of what we do, I think, is that we now in the 21st century are able to bring together a range of cutting-edge scientific methods for the first time to understand the deep past, techniques like ancient DNA. Only since 2010 have we been able to use these techniques in really to look at the deep story of humanity.